Thanks for being with us tonight. I'm Tiffany Kenny.
I'm Victor Blackwell. Now, this is still hundreds of miles out there, but some of the computer models predict the tropical system will be coming here to South Florida. Severe weather expert Mike Lyons is in the First Alert Weather Center with a new 5 o'clock advisory. Mike.
Yeah, we're waiting to find out officially from the National Hurricane Center. And I can tell you right now, they're not going to upgrade the system to a full-fledged tropical depression right now. And there's a very simple reason for it. We've got two different spins. Here's a look at the system right now. A mid-level spin right here, a low-level spin right here. Until the spins get stacked on top of each other, we will not have a tropical depression, at least not yet. But for the Caribbean islands, Guadeloupe, Martinique, Dominica, they're about to get hammered with rain squalls approaching 50 to 55 miles per hour. And heavy downpours tonight and again tomorrow. And as Victor and Tiffany pointed out, our computer models continue to suggest that Florida will be in play as we head towards Saturday and Sunday. I'll show you those computer models in just a second. Here's a look at the infrared satellite imagery. And as the hurricane hunters flew through here this afternoon, they found very high winds, 50 to 55 mile per hour winds. But again, not an organized system. It's a vigorous tropical wave, a vigorous tropical disturbance, but it has not organized yet because you have one spin here and another spin right here. And again, until they get lined up, you're not going to get a full-fledged system. So what's stopping the spins from getting together? Couple things. Number one, upper-level wind shear. Notice the winds kind of blowing in this general direction. Number two, African dust. Yeah, believe it or not, the dust gets entrained inside the system all the way from the Sahara. As the system moved off the coast of Africa about a week ago, that could prevent it as well. And finally, moving over land, like Hispaniola, for example, could cause the system to be rather weak. Eventually, it will come under the influence of this big trough of low pressure, and with a little bit of luck, maybe steer it out to sea. Here's what our computer models are showing. This is the 2 p.m. sweep, and you're looking at about 120 computer models. We're the only station in town that can show this many because we've got the TrueView Max, the latest weather technology. And as you can see, the models want to put Florida in play on Saturday and Sunday, bring it our way. We'll see what happens as we head down the road. So this is the week, if you have not done so yet, to download the WPBF Hurricane Tracker app. It's absolutely free. It's for the iPhone, the iPad, and the Android. Let me show you what we did today. We have apps actually increased the threat level across South Florida from 1 to 2. All right, we're not going to show it to you, but we'll show it to you later in the broadcast. We have a threat level when you go to the homepage. 1 is no concern. 2 is, yeah, we're a little concerned. We're watching the system, and that's how you should approach it as well. We're watching the system. By the way, just real quick, here in off the coast of Mexico, this is Hurricane Eugene. In the eastern Pacific, they've had 5 named storms, and they've had 5 hurricanes. This is the latest one, Eugene, packing winds of 75 miles per hour. More about what could become Emily and your local 7-day forecast when I come back in a couple minutes.